My name is Abdul Hoque, and I'm the director of a company called Selfix Technology. We are actually invent sort of new kind of materials for the community's benefit. And we have created something called squishy plastic. Along with that, we have other sort of like products that will be coming out in the future, something called Selfix and sticky wire as well. These are all to create sort of fun kind of impact within the community, especially to try and enhance learning by doing. That's our kind of motto. So we always like to see things happening practical ways, because if we make it practical ways, it gives benefits to the learners very much so. This is the pack that's actually going on sale this week, you know, on eBay. We've also been approaching different distributors for selling the squishy plastic. We also been working hard with the university. Last week I was actually demonstrating at Sheffield Hallam University jewellery design students. It was well received, and the tutor has taken about 40 packs of these to Hong Kong. And the day before yesterday, he was kind enough to actually send me back some video footages of Hong Kong students actually enjoying themselves very much so with squishy plastic, making different jewellery items.
Can you tell us a little bit about your background?
My background, I did engineering, especially metallurgical engineering at Sheffield City Polytechnic many years ago, and then worked in industry several years, and then decided I'd like to do a PhD with Rolls-Royce, especially focusing on gas turbine blades. After completion, I decided to enter a career into teaching. So I've been lecturing for quite a number of years, around 13 years, and then decided I need to set up a company to get these new products into the market, especially my enjoyment of practical way of doing things, and I want to pass that on to sort of community and school environment more for the learning enhancement. Basically, a pack has three colors, almost credit size, which can be kept in your wallet as if you wish. It's very simply plastic cards, hand-moldable for arts, craft, design, prototyping, fixing. It's really creating 3D parts without 3D printing for anything, basically, whatever your imagination desires. So today we will show you a few examples. It's very, very simple to use. All you do is you take hot water, insert a card in there, allow about a minute, 2 minutes to go a bit floppy, and then it's ready for molding to whatever you desire.
Great, and it's very light and bright, isn't
it? It's light and bright. We've actually created a bowl, and this serves as a bowl as well as a lampshade with a built-in solar system. So in daytime, this bowl could be sitting on your windowsill and charging. Nighttime, you turn it over, use it as a lampshade, a mood lampshade. Now, also, if you want to service your, like for example, cornflakes, rice crisps, whatever, still you can use it for that purpose as well. Cold cereals.
And the colours have merged together in that.
They do indeed. As I'm saying, the reason for creating sort of red, blue, and yellow is you can actually, as you wish, you can blend them into different requirements for different projects.
Can you tell us quickly how you use squishy plastic?
It's very simple. All you do is take out a card, pop it in hot water, allow 1 or 2 minutes for it to go malleable, and just take it out, and like Play-Doh, just start molding whatever you require. As I say, you can mold it into a shape by your hand molding, or you can actually cast it into a mold. It's quite nice and easy, really. And you have about a period of about 2 minutes to shape it. Then if you haven't finished the shape, put it back in hot water and continue until you finished. So it's really, really simple to use.
And it's reusable afterwards?
And you can reuse it again and again, many times as you wish. There's no issues with that. So if you've created a design you don't really like, pop it back in hot water, allow it to go malleable, take it out and reshape as you like. So if we boil the kettle first of all with water, once the water is boiled, we'll pour it into a cup. That could be like a plastic cup, but obviously you want to make sure like it's something that doesn't melt away. But usually a glass, a cup, you know, is okay for that purpose.
So at the moment the plastic is hard, solid.
It's hard, like, solid, rough like nylon, and it will bend, but it will not, it's very difficult to, as you will see, to break. It has some sort of flexibility. It's already boiled, so we're just pouring it into a cup. And all we do is simply take our squishy plastic, put it in there for about a minute or two, and keep watching it for changing its color to almost like, it's not going to go clear, but because of the pigment, but it will start to go floppy. But you got to obviously keep yourself safe, because obviously you're dealing with hot water, etc. If doing experiments like that with children, we suggest you make sure they're well supervised as well. A minute or two allows enough heat to go into the plastic so that you can actually almost play it like Play-Doh. You know, it will give you a duration of 2-3 minutes window frame to actually work. And if you haven't still finished the design successfully, you put it in hot water again and continue until you've, whatever your mind has desired to complete, you know, the project. So now we can start to take it out, and you'll see it sort of starts to stretch. You can twist it, turn it. If you slowly, you can draw it almost into like a wire form, a cord. And as I was saying, we are bringing out some courses around something called survival techniques or survival hacks using this material. And if you keep twisting, you can almost like create like a string. And you can roll it back into like a ball. And it's almost like a dough. And then you can, as I was saying, stretch it back again. So just like whatever you can do using Play-Doh, it's almost similar kind of, but you have obviously a minute or so, sorry, about 2 minutes window frame to work roughly. And you can mold it again and again, reshape, mold as you wish. Some of the people I've been trial testing with, they are currently using like a stress mechanism. So they make things, they put it back in hot water, and it's a fantastic way of stress relief. You know, like, you know, you can work with what's called stress balls. Instead of using a stress ball, this is a fantastic mechanism. I know one or two people at the moment, they are creating and destroying. It's amazing, you know. But I did tell them, make sure you capture a photograph of what you create, you know, so that you can recreate it as you wish again. We are also building this within the school curriculum to offer it to teachers so that they can actually use it in teaching aid within the community. Very, very important. Very important indeed. Now, for example, the launcher can be used in physics, maths, arts, craft, whatever. So even in gaming as well. So it allows like two people to have a game together so that they can, you know, look at statistics and things like that, whatever. Along with this, I've been taking different themes and experimenting as well, developing. So in one area, we actually experimented with incorporating electronics. Mood Lab is just one example, but you could put in like loudspeaker sound effect. Obviously, light is there, sensor effects. Interesting thing about this material and everything is creating 3D parts without 3D printing needs. I'm really enjoying it, and I want to bring this out to the community for future enjoyments as well, much as possible. So we've actually started off at home. Now we actually want to move into proper manufacturing premise where we can employ a few more people from our local community, especially Sheffield. We have a passion for Sheffield and want to see more growth in Sheffield indeed. And obviously the only thing that really would help is obviously we want more people to learn about it. So we want to do major kind of like a campaign in order to go into schools and various other places. But we at the moment are a small organization lacking fundings and things like that. So we could do a bit with help from the locality to really take this project mainstream. And as it grows, it should be able to marry within other cities. So we do want to give it to everybody the opportunity. Especially, it will definitely enhance learning and many other aspects.
And it sticks to itself as well. You don't need to glue it.
It almost can act as an adhesive in its own right. So to actually join two pieces together, like earlier on we demonstrated the catapult, which comes in three different parts. So you just pop it in hot water, dip in, dip out, and just press them together to join. Simple as that.
Great. And are people going to be able to buy it soon in the shops?
Yes, we are actually at the moment looking at the eBay market and Amazon. However, also we are doing a marketing campaign to get them into different stores, so like craft stores, possible distributor shops, but still in the thinking phase which direction to go in terms of which shops is going to be bought, definitely on eBay.
Great. So finally, Abdul, can you tell us how people find out more about Squishy Plastik?
We have a website called www.selfixtechnology.com. They can go and visit that and find out everything about it, no problem. We are a Sheffield-based company. We are looking towards expanding, creating job opportunities. Any support, anything would be useful, even if people actually go and buy something from the eBay and try it out. That's really, really helping a Sheffield company progress. And obviously, anything that they've created can go in our gallery section as well. So they can post a picture, we can add it to the gallery section.
And it has many, many uses, including jewellery.
Jewellery, toys, fixing, making. We just leave it to education. We just leave it to the imagination of the people.